So, thank you for the introduction, Damien. I'm Julien Regues, one of the statisticians at Diana Pet Food, and I'm going to talk about less data, similar events, optimizing the paired comparisons, sensory evaluation. So you are going to see a lot of pictures for cats and dogs, as you might notice on the introduction slide. So Diana Pet Food mission is to improve pets' well-being and pet owner satisfaction. So the idea is to create a brand which meets the expectation of three different parts: the pets as the consumers, the pet owners as the purchaser of the product, and the pet fooder who are going to manufacture our product. To assess the product performance, Diana Pet Food built a tool called Panelist, which is a unique research tool constituted of 940 cats and dogs, which represent more than 60 different breeds. This expert center runs more than 8,000 tests per year, located on three expert sites, one in France, one in Brazil, and one in the USA, and hired around 82 experts to take care of the animals and to run what we call the palatability test. Okay, basically, to assess the food preferences in the domain of pet food, the idea is to give two balls to the ear to the dogs. You can see he's quite enjoying the food, so you will give him two balls, and the idea is to record the intake of the two balls and to calculate an intake ratio of food A and food B, so A divided by A plus B and B divided by A plus B. And what we say also is if the ratio of food A is higher than food B, the product A is the winner. But the idea is more to rank several products. And when you want to rank this several product, the idea is to conduct what we call the Bradley design or Bradley model, inspired from the name Bradley-Terry model. So the idea is to compare all the product versus each other in a versus test, and then run a Bradley statistical analysis to obtain a Bradley score associated to each product. And this score will give you the performance ranking of your product. So this score is comprised between 0 and 1, and the sum of all the score is equal to 1. And the, obviously, higher is the score, better is the product for the animal. While in Bradley model, sky is the limit. Well, not that much. In fact, the Bradley model main drawback is when the product number increase, the test number exponentially increase. And as you can see on the right graph, if you, for instance, you have 16 product to rank, you need to run 120 paired comparison test, which is a huge number of tests. So the idea is to see how to reduce the number of tests or the number of data involved in Bradley design. So the objective and strategy was to do what we have called the sustainable statistics, while the idea is to optimize the number of data without weakening the relevance of the analysis. To do so, we have put in place two different strategies. The first one is to try to reduce the number of individuals involved in Bradley design. And the second one was to reduce the number of pairs within the Bradley design. So run what we called incomplete Bradley design. Let's focus on the second part of the strategy. We have also split this strategy in two different parts, what we have called random or targeted removal. So here you have a graph of a result of Bradley design with 8 products and 28 paired comparisons. The point represents the absolute difference between the ratio A and B. So higher is the ratio, higher is the difference between the two products. The first strategy was to randomly remove the pairs. So as you can see, the red cross here is are the points we are going to remove from the Bradley design, or target the pair we want to remove. And here we have applied three different strategies. remove, sorry, the smallest difference per removal. So on the bottom of the graph, the second strategy was to remove the hugest, the highest difference pair. And the third one was to remove both smallest, one smallest, and then the highest, the most smallest, the second smallest, the second highest, and so on. Okay, and the idea was to see which strategy was more suitable to keep the reliability of our design. So the method, thanks to Panelis Expert Center, we have gathered a huge number of design. So the design are always made on 40 cats or 40 dogs. And we have gathered more than 600 design, different design, on a 10 years interval, with 4 to 17 products compared. This represents a huge amount of more than 8,000 palatability tests. So the idea is to take this complete Bradley score, as you can see here on the picture, and then apply the two strategies, reduce the number of individuals or the number of pairs, simulating 1,000 times, and then compare this simulation obtained, so the incomplete Bradley score, with the complete one. To do this comparison, thanks to the literature, we have put in place three different criteria to assess the reliability between the complete and incomplete Bradley score. So first one was the Euclidean distance between these two scores. The second one was the correlation coefficient. And the third one was the number of significantly different pairs of product inside the incomplete Bradley score compared to the complete Bradley score. On these three criteria, we have specified a specific threshold, and we take the minimum value between the three criteria, and then the maximum number of removable data will be the quartile at 25%. You will see after it will be clearer with the results, I guess. So let's go to the results. To create guidelines for this data reduction, a minimum number of design was necessary. So the idea here is to see with a table the number of Bradley design associated to the number of product compared and to the species of the pet, so dog or cats. And we have decided to display guidelines if we have 8 or more complete design per category of product number. And as you can see, to obtain this number, we will focus only on the Bradley containing up to 8 product comparisons, because after we won't have enough data to be reliable and relevant for the analysis. So first strategy, the reduction of the number of individuals. Here is again the same example with you have per criterion assessed. So this first graph represents the evolution of the mean distance between complete and incomplete Bradley score on the 1,000 simulation with the specific threshold chosen here at 0.04. And as you can see here, you can remove up to 24 individuals with this threshold. Then the correlation coefficient, so we target a threshold at 97%, and up to 20 tools. And for the number of significantly different pair, here the number was up to 13 removable individuals. So here the limiting threshold is the third criterion, the number of significantly different pair. So on this specific Bradley design with 8 products, we can remove a maximum of 13 individuals without impairing too much results obtained. So now is the box or the blocks plot for each type of pet. So dog in red and cat in green, blue-green. And the on the x-axis, the number of products in each design. So the quantile 25% would be the value taken to display the guidelines. So as you can see, you can, for instance, when you have 8 products to compare and you are in dogs, you can remove up to 11 dogs in your design. So 11 dogs for each paired comparison test. So that's quite a huge decrease because, you know, we were from a panel of 40 dogs and we reduced to up to 30 dogs, you know, so it's 1/4 of reduction. Now, second strategy, reducing the number of pairs. So first, the random pairs removal. So as you can see here, the results are pretty tough because it's difficult to remove pairs of products when you don't have a lot of products to compare in your Bradley design. So you can begin to remove some pairs of products from 7 products compared, both in cats and dogs. But you have to, under this number, under 7, it's quite difficult to, it's quite risky to remove pairs of products. If we focused on the strategy smallest difference pairs removal, then you can see that you can remove more more pairs of products. For instance, one pairs of product both in cats and dogs when you have 5 products to compare, and up to 8 pairs of products when you have 8 products to compare. So here again, the reduction is quite relevant. You know, it represents more than 1/4 reduction again of data. The two other strategies we have tried were not as relevant as the smallest difference pair removal. As you can see on the guidelines displayed here, it's again quite difficult to remove some pairs of product when you have under 7 product to be compared. So in conclusion, while both strategies are quite relevant, you can both decide to reduce the number of individual or to reduce the number of pair. The best way when you choose to reduce the number of pairs is to remove the pair with the less differences between products. If, of course, obviously, if you don't know the predicted level of palatability, if you don't have any prior information, then you can just follow the guidelines with the random pairs removal. Okay, so here is all the guideline displayed for people in R&D in order to reduce the number of data. And obviously what we have demonstrated is that it's possible to optimize the number of tests and the data with what we have called incomplete Bradley design. The best strategy for us to decrease the data number without weakening the relevance of the analysis is to remove the pairs of product with a similar level of palatability. So if people have prior information of expected palatability, then it should focus on removing only the smallest difference of pairs. And without this knowledge on expected palatability, the random removal of pairs is also feasible, despite a lower reliability or a lower number of pairs of products removed. And again, individual removal is possible, but because it's more difficult to set up in panelists, we will avoid this solution and focus only on pairs reduction. I thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Julien. Yep. It's time for question. Do you have some question for to Julien?
Maybe one short question from my side. Nicolas speaking, not specific to maybe this topic in particular, but it's often that we try to see how far we can reduce something from a starting point. Do you think you'll have found the same result if you would have started from sample size that was the double? Let's say you said you had panel of 40 dogs and you go to 30. What if you would have had 80 or 20? Do we go to the same answers in the end? Because it's always a bit the issue. We tried it in a different context to reduce size of a panel. Let's say you start with 100 and you see that 80 is not so bad. You start from 50, you find that 40 is not that bad. Any view on that?
Yeah, it's true. I guess if you start at 11 and you go to 1, you will see that the results are bad. But no, indeed, the starting point is key. It's a rule we have set up to keep our panel at 40. But I would expect different results if we go for instance 100 and we reduce to 60 to add to 60. Mm-hmm. But I think the key of this is the more data you have, the more you can reduce the data. You know, and it's the same with the number of products. I'm pretty sure if you have like 12 or more products to compare, you can take only the half of the Bradley design and it will be quite relevant as well.
Mm-hmm. But then isn't there a matter of, I don't know, power behind that makes that, you know, really right where to stop? Because the question, the business question behind is, what's the right number so that I don't pay too much, but I have real valid information? I don't have the answer, huh? It's just really an open point. But I think it's always about the question we may have in different contexts. And it's not that easy to know what's really making the rule in the end.
Mm. Yeah, it's true. The idea behind all this simulation was, in fact, to show the business it's still useful to perform Bradley design, because nowadays our business stuck at only one palatability test, and for us statisticians it's not as relevant. So we really want to push people in R&D to perform more trials, and especially more Bradley design trials, because it's more relevant. And the idea behind is to say, okay, it will cost you more tests, but you can reduce the data somehow and still keep a good reliability of the results.
Mm-hmm. It brings me exactly this kind of discussion for us as well. Thank you.
We've got a question in the chat, Julien, from Eugénie Chanel. How have you chosen the threshold values? You can see the question?
Yeah, okay. How have you chosen the threshold value? Example given 80, 98, 87 for correlation, why not 95 or 99? Well, this threshold is always a question of MITRE. One p-value at 5%, I would say. No, it was based on one of the literature I have read on this specific topic of incomplete Bradley design, and the guy has chosen 98% in correlation, so I took the same threshold quite basically. I don't have better answer than that.
Okay, and there is a second question. She doesn't understand the targeted pair removal approach.
As normally you have to have the data to remove it, so the effort of data acquisition is already done or not. Yeah, true. But the idea behind is to conduct incomplete Bradley design. So we take the complete Bradley design to make simulation on it and to try to remove the data in different way and to see which way impairs the less the results compared to the complete Bradley score and Bradley design.
It means that a researcher should have a strong experience and strong knowledge about the product to choose the right product to the right pair to test.
Yeah, sure. But most of the time when we speak to the researcher, we can see that he wants to rank 8 products, but he already have a prior knowledge of which product are going to be different and which one are going to be the same. So yeah, it's possible. Does it exist a panel of humans to test the pet food also? Or you only judge the food and pets appreciation? Well, indeed, we have also an enormous panel. So basically, the pet owner tests only the smell and the form or the color of the kibble of the pet food, and the pets will test the taste of the pet food. But however, that some panel exist in human as well, to try both wet pet food or dry kibble. I've tried myself, and it's not very tasty, to be honest.
Okay. Do we have any other question? And do you have often some test with 20 products, or I don't know, 17 products? It's huge for to evaluate.
Yeah, it's very expensive. No, it's not. It's not quite common. It's really It's linked to let's say PhD thesis. So we did it twice. It's really not common. Yeah.
It's why you focused on less than 8 products.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, time for another question, maybe. No. Don't hesitate to ask directly or by chat. We're going to. Do you
why
see
a doing pair comparisons and not 3-4 product at a time? Well, because it's very hard to train. It's already hard to train the animals to test 2 products and to show them they have to choose between 2 products. You know, some of our animals are stuck in a left ball or right ball, so. When you try 3 or 4 products at a time, it's completely the mess. We tried, but it doesn't work at all. We tried 4 at a time, and it doesn't work at all.
And we've got another question from Gaëtan Laureau. Hello.
Yes. Do you see a lot of difference between cat and dog data? Yes, obviously. I'm not sure it's linked to the pet of the product we developed, but we see much higher difference in dogs than in cats in our panel in terms of differences between products. But I'm not sure it's linked to the pets or to the ability to the pets to test in the 2 balls. So Philippe, yes, Julien, when I remove products, this pair are removed for all individual. Or did you use balance in complete design? No, I don't use balance in complete design. I am thinking about using this balance in complete design, but the pair are in fact removed for all individual. So it's really a missing data, a missing pairs.